Hello again. Hello. If we can just take our seats, please, so we can move to the next session. So this is planned to finish at around 1 for lunch, but please remember that the companies will be here until late afternoon. Okay, you can speak to them. Ask me or my colleagues or directly the representatives of the companies to arrange a meeting. So, as I said, schematically, this is the second part and concerns the investment framework, investment opportunities in Greece. And to kick off this session, we have a representative of Enterprise Greece. So Enterprise Greece is the official agency of the Greek state. Under the supervision of the Ministry of Economy and Development, with the task of showcasing Greece as an attractive destination for investment and to promote the highly competitive products and services produced in Greece. The speaker is Konstantinos Angelopoulos. Thank you very much for being here. He's the Director of Investment Promotion of Enterprise Greece, and he has been working for many years as a policy advisor and business facilitator, and he has gained experience working as a member of the board of directors of companies, public authorities, and committees. And he has also been promoting dozens of investment projects and business plans around the world. So, Konstantine, thank you very much for being here.
Good morning, everybody. Thank you very much, Thanas, for the introduction, and thank you very much for the invitation. We are very glad to be in London again and have a presentation about the about investment opportunities in Greece in tourism and healthcare sectors, which are very important sectors and growth sectors for our country. We used to, as an agency, for those of you that you don't know us, we are the official investment and trade promotion agency of Greece under the Ministry of Economy and Development. Our aim is to promote exports of goods and services from Greece to foreign countries and to attract investments in Greece. That's why we have an action plan of around 40 outreach activities per year around the globe. So we travel a lot and we are trying to promote Greece and attract investors. We are trying to say the good word about our country. We have many things to offer in many investors in many sectors. And we have a unique investment proposition, as we call it, which combines timeless competitive advantages, the location at the crossroads of three continents, natural resources available, the high quality human capital. Greece is a developed country, member of the Eurozone. The stability is there, the framework, the rule of law is there, very good infrastructure in many sectors and networks. And at the same time, Greece offers opportunities that are usually offered by emerging economies. So because of the program that we are implementing, many reforms have been taking place in Greece. Markets are opening, the asset developments are happening in many sectors. Public assets are being privatized, and there are many growth sectors. And of course, somebody would say, okay, Konstantinos, you are working for Enterprise Greece, so this is the things that you should tell because you are promoting Greece, but it's not only us. Here you can see on this slide a very recent study from Berenbank, German investment bank, which states that They assess the performance of 28 countries and economies in the European Union, and Greece scores number one in fiscal repair. They are tracking this performance since 2009 up to 2016, and Greece is at the top of this list. They use five criteria, as you can see, and Greece scores number one in fiscal repair and structural reforms over these years, second in labor costs, and top five in external adjustment. So it's not only us that we are promoting the good word about Greece. Foreign direct investment in this framework that we are trying to promote Greece and attract investments is a key priority for us, as you can understand. Last year in 2016, I don't know how many of you know that we had a record year in the last 10 years in foreign direct investments. So we received 2.8 billion euros in FDIs. In this year, 2017, according to the data from the Bank of Greece, the official data, we see an increase of, for the first half of the year, an increase of 150%. So this year, again, will be a record year for FDI. In terms of sectors, as we are discussing here about tourism and healthcare sectors, you can see on this graph that tourism and real estate sectors are important sectors for FDIs. We have seen during the last 7 years representing from 15 up to 40% of the total FDIs. Last year, from the 2.8 billion euros of foreign direct investments in Greece, around 800 million euros came from these sectors. Following up, we can see on this slide some selective indicative deals that have happened during these difficult years since 2011. You can see on this slide important US, European, Chinese companies invested in many sectors in Greece: tourism and real estate, food and beverage, infrastructure, of course, pharmaceuticals, technology, etc., and manufacturing. The sectors that we are promoting are the sectors that are attracting also the interest from foreign direct investors. So tourism and real estate is an important sector, agri-food, energy, both traditional sources and renewable, logistics, of course, ICT, what we call information and communications technologies, life sciences, and this connects our presentation to the healthcare sector, cultural and creative industry, which is a small relatively sector, but it's very vibrant in Greece and it has a big potential, and of course the privatization agenda. In terms of tourism, of course everybody knows that Greece is in the top of the list of many reports concerning to tourism attraction and the number of tourists that we receive. In 2017, as you most probably know, it will be for the fifth year in a row that Greece will break its all-time record in tourist arrivals. So many tourists are coming to Greece and they are exploring not only the country but also investment opportunities. Tourist receipts will exceed 15 billion euros this year. So it's not a surprise that tourism is an export champion for Greece. It represents 18.6% of GDP and almost 24% of employment. Especially Athens, apart from the islands that are very famous, especially Athens has seen also a 60% increase in arrivals in the last 3 years. So new destinations are opening up all over the country, like the one that we saw before, and foreign hotel chains are establishing or expanding their presence in Greece. The opportunities in this sector, we believe that lie in some specific subsectors. We have highlighted here seven. So one is upgrade existing infrastructure of existing developments, and this is a trend that we have seen. The new developments that are happening in Greece are on the ultra luxury side of the market. So please note that in 2000 we had around 1% of our hotels being in the five-star category, and now it's up to 5%. And the new developments in new destinations or existing destinations, they are focusing on these five-star or six-star categories. Large integrated resorts are in the pipeline or are in the process to be constructed right now. Integrated resorts that combine five-star hotels, holiday homes, and other facilities and amenities. Cruiser marinas is a very interesting sector that we see a growing interest, especially for the development of new marinas. Thematic parks and tourism, sport tourism, there are a lot to be done in this sector in order to take advantage of the cultural heritage of the country. Medical and health tourism is a subsector with great potential if you take account the weather and the number of physicians that exist in the population, the privatization of publicly owned assets attracted main interest from both European, US, and Asian investors, and of course, the city break experience that both the Ministry of Tourism is promoting. A very interesting program that attracts the interest from many countries and has supported the tourism and real estate sectors during the last years is what we call the Golden Visa Program. It's a program that grants permanent residence permits to investors, non-European investors that buy real estate assets in Greece, and this also helps new investments in integrated tourism resorts. As you can see on this slide, we have already 5,000 residence permits granted to investors and their family members, and we estimate that there has been around 1.2 billion euros direct flows into the country from this program. Our agency, since 2013, that the program first announced, and in 2015 actually we had the final view as it is now, we have started promoted this program heavily around the globe. So we have created a specific logo, a video that all of you can use, that you are promoting the program. We organize national pavilions in big exhibitions around the globe, in China, in Middle East, in Russia. We have produced brief guides that you can find in our website in five languages, Greek, English, Chinese, Arabic, and Russian. And we also operate the front office to receive inquiries and any help that is needed from the companies. On this slide, you can see a breakdown of the program in terms of the markets. You can see that China is the first market, Russia the second, Turkey the third, and Middle Eastern countries mainly follow. This is the slide for all family members. Probably the UK would be a new destination lately. We were in Australia 2 weeks ago, and everybody was asking about the program, not only for them, but only for their UK fellows. In the sector of tourism, we see not only small, medium-sized investments, but also major investments that are underway, of course, both in the infrastructure side. So we see a very big investment, as you probably know, from Fraport, when German-Greek consortium gained a tender to upgrade 14 regional airports. It's a 3 billion, in total, 3 billion euro deal. And they gained the 40-year consensus to operate, manage, develop, and maintain the facilities. These are significant investments because they will upgrade the services that are provided by these airports to many famous tourism destinations in Greece. And also we have private investments under the privatization program that are taking place. One of them is here on this slide, Astir Palias in Athens. We had a successful tender 2-3 years ago, and now the investment is taking place. But apart from this, Mr. Theodoridis talked about Costa Navarino in the previous session. Mr. Kaburidis, who is here, Dolphin Capital created in the crisis a very important destination in Argolida, and actually it was the first Amani resort that operated in Europe, not only in Greece, during these years. Other significant investments in Chalkidiki, on the end of the slide here you can see the biggest probably spa resort in the Mediterranean, Miraggio. And on the next two slides, we have collected indicatively some deals. The latest announcement for the new luxury development in Kea Island between Kersen and Dolphin Capital. TUI Group, who is continuously investing in Greece in many destinations. U.S. Heinz, which acquired with some Greek companies ex-Lidra Hotel in Athens. Other German tour operators. U.S. Oaktree Capital, which together with Greek Sun S.A. expands in the Greek tourist market with new hotels. the development of a Ellinikon project with Chinese Fosun and Emirati Eagle Hills, an 8 billion project in Athens, Marriott and Wyndham Hotel Group, private investors from Saudi Arabia with a very big investment in Evia Island, the Amman Resort that we discussed, Russian Mirum, which implements Eluda Hills in Crete Island, Four Seasons that will launch the new Astir Palace in Vouliagmeni, Somewhere Hotels, the Saudi group, M&G Investments, I think that they are here today in this conference. They entered with Grivalia in a joint venture and they are investing in Thessaloniki and Athens Riviera, and Accor Hotels, which opens new hotels in Greece. Going to the second sector of our today's workshop and connecting the two, we believe that there are many things to be done in Greece to take advantage of both tourism and healthcare. So what connects the two sectors is health tourism. This is a global rising trend because people want to go and find the perfect solution for them. And most of the times, not the most, the cheapest, but the solution that can combine the, a very good doctor, a very good environment, and of course the cost factor. So we are talking about an industry that is valued at 100 billion euros, around 11 million individuals travel every year abroad to in search of medical services. And there are reports from Visa and Oxford Economics that say that there will be up to 2025 an increase of 25% per year in this subsector. And we believe that Greece can pinpoint itself in this very important sector. Why? Because we have the infrastructure. We rank 24th among 145 countries in tourism infrastructure. We have the highest ranking in what we call the health and hygiene sub-indexed in the competitiveness index of the World Economic Forum. And we are among the top countries, the third actually, among 136 countries in terms of physician density per 1,000 people. So there are very good doctors available in Greece. There is a very good hospital infrastructure, both public and private, that could be exploited. And there are already popular treatments in Greece, like orthopedic surgery, eye surgery, dental centers, medical diagnostic centers, plastic cosmetics and treatments. So we see a trend. There are some new business associations that have been set up to promote, and there is an effort to promote this sector, the new medical sector for Greece to foreign countries. The opportunity for Greece is that we are an established tourism destination. The location is very favorable because we can combine and treat both European patients, patients from Russia, patients from the Middle East. You know, even Australia is very close to Greece. Greece is the first European country that they can reach. Mild climate, availability of health infrastructure, educated and multilingual personnel, important the Greek diaspora in many target markets like the US, Europe, Australia. The cost is an important factor and we are doing very well, and complementarity with other sectors. Latest deals in what we call medical healthcare sector that attracted the interest of foreign investors is the acquisition of the Metropolitan Hospital Group from CVC Capital Partners. They are already in a binding agreement to acquire 97% of the share capital in EASO General. Afidea, which is a European company and expanded recently, reaching a network of 17 diagnostic centers. And of course, investments in what we call the health tourism sector of spa and treatment resorts. More deals are expected. People in the market say that the healthcare sector will be a top sector in attracting new investments, both Greek and foreign investments in 2018. There are some hospitals that will be tender, but also private partners that are looking for private investors to either expand their portfolio or create new destinations. As mentioned in the at the beginning. Enterprise Greece, which is the agency that I represent, is the official agency of Greece to promote investments in Greece. We facilitate investors, so if you need any help in doing business in Greece, about information about Greek economy, about sectors, or even if you are looking to find incentives and if you are looking to find a specific project, we also promote a portfolio of investment opportunities in almost any sector. Our services are offered, of course, free of charge to any investor which is interested to explore investment opportunities in Greece. There is also a framework that we are promoting, and we are the front office of this framework, which is called Fast Track. So for big investment projects that we call strategic investments, there is a Fast Track procedure to licensing them. So we have already 15 projects approved of 3.7 billion euros, and there are 8 more projects in the pipeline. This is a procedure that wants to facilitate difficult big projects. There is also available what we call the New Investment Incentives Law, which is a law that supports new investments in Greece in almost any sector. Tourism sector is included. The healthcare sector is not included. Only health tourism sector is included in the map. And there are tax exemptions, cash grants and leasing subsidies, as you can see. We can give you more information if you are interested on that. There is a very favorable and very interesting framework in Greece. For those of you that you don't know, it's called the Intragroup Service Centers Framework. It's a framework that gives opportunity to big multinational company to establish their back office operations in Greece. It could be consulting services. It could be, for example, a new company or an office of a multinational company that gives and sells services to companies of the group that are located either in Greece or abroad. So these back office centers could provide consulting services, centralized accounting services, quality control of production, preparation of studies, advertising and marketing services. We have seen already 160 Greek or foreign companies establishing their presence through this framework in Greece. And we see a very big trend for multinational companies to take advantage of this framework. There is some new legislation having to do with the data protection in Europe, and companies that have established their back office operations and data centers in Middle Eastern countries or in Africa or in Asia, they are trying to bring them back in Europe so that they are safe how their data are treated. The advantages of this program is the flexibility with regard to the type of the business entity. It simplifies the transparent licensing process through the one-stop shop service in the Ministry of Economy and Development. There is a legal certainty because there is a predefined profit margin on the costs of this center. And there is also the opportunity to give residence and work permits for all the foreign staff of the company. And at the same time, they will not be treated as expats. So even if they stay all year round in Greece, they will not be taxed for their global income, only for the income from this company. I would like to end my presentation with a slide showing the confidence that big international financial organizations are showing to Greece and investments in Greece. So the last years we have seen an increasing and significant support from institutions and financial organizations like European Investment Bank. They recently announced that they will continue to finance projects in Greece. They will finance more than 2 billion projects in 2018, and they will enter the tourism sector. They have already financed projects of more than 7 billion during the last years. Of course, their subsidiary European Investment Fund is in Greece and will finance projects both from the Equi Fund, that it's a new fund of funds to support Greek SMEs and venture capital firms. As you probably know, European Bank, EBRD for Reconstruction and Development, is is present in Greece the last 2.5 years, and they have been already financed 24 projects with a budget of 1.3 billion euros. Black Sea Trade and Development Bank also provides financing for projects in Greece, and IFC of World Bank has already financed 10 projects in the financial sector, infrastructure, real estate and insurance. So I will be glad to welcome any of you to ask any questions and bring you in contact with projects and opportunities in Greece. Thank you very much.
Okay, thank you very much, Kyria Angelopoulou, Konstantinos. Let's move ahead. Let's now hear from Ricard Skoufias, the Managing Director of ClearBridge Partners, with over 20 years experience managing international relations and business development across Europe, Asia, Africa, and the Americas. And most recently, from 2011 to 2017, he has led the Trans-Adriatic Pipeline in Greece, TAP, one of Greece's largest investments in excess of 1.5 billion euros. So he does have a very direct and hands-on experience of leading major investments into Greece. He has kindly agreed to share a few of his interesting observations about challenges, opportunities, and of course, key success factors in investing in Greece. Thank you very much.
So at least I'll try to make it interesting. So the first thing that came to my mind here today is that, of course, as I address an audience of investors, I try to think of my friends who is in that space, and what they tend to focus on is, what's the opportunity? What's the return? What's the risk? So I'll keep that in mind as I give you my short address. So there has been a lot of talk now in the recent months about foreign investment in Greece. Senior officials, including the Prime Minister himself during last and recent state visits, made some very strong overtures towards the global investor community. And from what we're hearing, there seems to be little doubt that there are potential opportunities ahead. Just very briefly looking at the energy sector, which is one that I'm intimately familiar with. Greece is already leveraging its geographic, very strategic position as a gateway into Europe for new sources of energy from the Caspian and the Near East. The pipeline that was mentioned, that's in total a 4.5 billion euro pipeline, is today in full construction, and it will be an essential component in opening up a new energy corridor from Azerbaijan into Europe worth approximately $45 billion in totality. And Greece is playing a protagonist role on this development. And from this project, of course, there will be an additional number of bilateral and multilateral endeavors converting Greece basically into a regional hub in the Balkan region. Recent developments around Cyprus and Israel has also shown that Greece is quite possibly in possession of oil and gas reserves, which is already perking the interest of some of the international energy majors. And of course, there is the ongoing deals in the investment in the insurance sphere, in harbors, ports, and of course the privatization program. So there is a lot of developments going on at the moment. In parallel, of course, however, we've also seen more than one media story about challenges to international investors, some which have taken a beating on the share price for reasons which are depicted as, you know, complexities of doing business in Greece. So what do the numbers tell us? I'll not repeat what was said before, but if we look at the OECD restrictiveness index, which basically measures statutory restrictions on FDI, Greece actually performs better than the OECD average. So in simple terms, this means that from a statutory perspective, Greece is a less restrictive FDI destination. In terms of protecting investor interest, I saw a report recently by Santander Bank and Doing Business, which pointed out that in terms of transaction transparency and the general investor protection, Greece scores rather well. It actually scores better than, for example, Germany. The business confidence index is clawing itself back. It took a dip in 2015, but is today coming up on parity with the EU and OECD average. And as was mentioned by the previous speaker, I believe that the expectation by the Ministry of Economy for FDI this year is 4 billion. That is a fourfold increase from 2015 and up 25% from last year. So these are very strong indicators depicting positive trends. And yet a recent study, I think it was Ernst & Young who published it, and it had quite a lot of coverage in Greek media, showed that despite these positive trends, only a very negligible part of FDI actually makes its way into Greece. So that, of course, beckons the question, is Greece a pretty girl that people are still a little bit too afraid to dance with? And I think that, to an extent, the answer is yes. So thinking a little bit about the situation that I've had for the last couple of years, investment of this magnitude have got a social and political impacts. The Greek political system has exhibited volatility over the last couple of years, and it still leaves some to be desired in terms of predictability as a major investor. And after almost a decade of what's probably the worst socioeconomic crisis that Europe has seen since the Second World War, which has put immense strain on the Greek people and which permeates society at all levels, these are factors that need to be taken into account. But to draw the conclusion from those facts that investing in Greece today would entail insurmountable country risk, which is often discussed in these conferences, or that there is a concern about constructive engagement with the authorities, etc., I think that is grossly erroneous. This is my experience. I think, on the contrary, Greece is going through an immense change. It is definitely in the right direction. And in my experience, it is from a real and genuine desire and commitment to now seize a lot of the opportunities. Some of you will know that when I took over the pipeline project in 2011, it had actually been vociferously opposed for years by the Greek government. It had become an untenable situation, and it definitely needed a complete change of approach. As I stepped down just recently this year, I left a project behind that had outstanding support by the Greek government. And that was actually across the full political spectrum. A project where, going into the actual critical details, all the permits were not only in place, but in many cases had been granted by the various ministries with an efficiency that was equal or better to any best-in-class European administration. So that journey from the initial challenge to subsequently finding actually really good means of building what I would today describe as a very genuine and long-standing relationship with the Hellenic Republic and with the interlocutors did leave me with a few observations. And I thought that I would share just three of them very briefly with you today. My first one is that somebody like me, who stands with one leg in Athens and one leg in London and a little bit all over the place, I believe that the prevailing sentiment internationally regarding Greece is still broadly determined by a lot of the reporting that has for years now reported and focused on crisis and volatility. I think this is unfortunate. I think that it is increasingly misguided, and I think it's definitely time to change that. Which takes me to my second observation. Greece, of course, has the responsibility to change external perceptions. And in parallel to all these ongoing reforms, I am a strong proponent that Greece should accelerate its focused effort to debunk these negative sentiments and now set the record straight by really a targeted crusade by both the governing and the business classes. A lot of this work is already undergoing on this respect, and I think today, and in particularly with the previous speaker, is good evidence of this. But of course, in my mind, the goal is only reached when prospective international investors know what are the words and what are the proof points on the Greek hymn sheets for investment. I don't think we are there yet, but I think there is a good hymn sheet. And my final observation, and I think most critical probably for an audience like this, who might be looking at potential investment, is every business environment is complex. But with its political history, with the geographic location between East and West, and a very long extended period of economic and societal crisis, I would say that Greece is just maybe more complex. As the example of the project that we've been discussing, that does, however, not mean that Greece cannot be a very successful destination. But I think I would be so daring as to say that a prerequisite for that success is also that investors, at least at this period, are also willing to invest in both understanding and addressing some of the complexities and dynamics that go into a major investment into geography that has undergone what Greece has undergone for the last couple of years. Looking just for a very brief moment at the privatization program, I think this is a perfect example of something that cannot be reduced to simple transactional equations. Privatization touches quite deep on national sentiment, not only because of being driven to sell off national assets, but also because in some cases this actually goes to the very heart of the socio-political model that the country may wish to embark on. So investors who are looking at entering that space, I would say, would be very well advised to also assess and try to address some of those dynamics. So just to round up in conclusion, after having now spent about 7 years largely in Athens with weekly interaction with government and business and the diplomatic community, I think I've had some opportunity to see what works from an investment perspective and what does not. Greece has got some critical work ahead of it, but I am one who actually have unwavering confidence. I think that future is intrinsically linked to international investors. And my unequivocal advice, as I would advise them, is afford to make the investment, ideally as early as possible, also in the underlying drivers, tap into the socio-political, the cultural, and the relationship dynamics that surround any investment of this magnitude beyond the mere economics. I will guarantee that the return on that investment, at least, will be significant, if not maybe a key determination for your future success. So thank you very much for your attention.
Thank you, Mr. Skoufias, for these encouraging messages. So this is the last presentation of this part of the day before lunch and the networking lunch. And I will invite Panagiotis Dragoumanos, who is Head of Investment Projects Development at Noesis Development Consultants. As I said earlier, Noesis run a very big portfolio of investments, and they are one of the beneficiaries of the investment law in Greece. Mr. Dragoumanos, thank you very much.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. I'm trying to be to make my presentation as fast as it can be because I know that we are a lot of hours here. So Noises was established in 1998, providing specialized and consulting services to companies and organizations in the private and the public sector, mainly in private sector. We are the leading company in Greece regards to investment projects, financing and management. We make available to our colleagues the financial instruments offered by the Greek state and the European Union, such as the development law. I'm going to tell you later about this useful tool. We have three offices situated in Athens, Thessaloniki and Western Macedonia and the city of Kastoria, if anyone knows where it is. We handle a large portfolio of subsidized projects which are either complete and for sale or under construction in search of investors. The specific projects are already approved to receive state subsidy and thus are expected to have a high investment yield because all these investment projects have already approval from the investment law to be under this umbrella of funding. And about from 10 to 35% of the whole budget to complete the investment, it will be paid from the European Union under the NSFR, if you know, National Strategic References Framework of 2014 to 2020 for the Greece. Noises also provide aid to local and foreign investors claiming assets from the Hellenic Republic Assets Development Fund. The Hellenic Republic Development Fund runs all the privatization program for the Hellenic Republic. A lot of public assets, such as resorts, companies, anything will be privatized for the next years. And so we providing services in this sector. And of course, we have a great knowledge of the legislation that converts the licensing of hotel units, tourist complexes, and provide this kind of consulting. This is our services. First of all, our core business, financing investment projects from the development law of Greece. Second, all necessary services for investment in assets from the Hellenic Republic Asset Development Fund, the TAIPED, if you know in Greek language. Real estate services for investments, services in all kinds of licensing procedures, and of course, financing investment projects from the Greek banks. Investment project management, strategic business plan, business organization providing service to the public sector. A few numbers about us. The last years, establishment of hotel units, more than 50,000 beds. Extensions and modernization of hotel units for more than 70,000 beds, and the most of them under the umbrella of the investment law. Investments in renewable energy sources, more than 2.5 gigawatts. Major investments in industry and logistics, more than 3,100 square meters. And the last period of application to the investment law, we apply for 97 investment projects in about half a billion euros. And this is about the 45% of the whole Greek market. And now let's talk about the development law. First of all, I'd like to tell you about the development law. What is development law? I'd like to make you understand what is development law. The new development law, it has its number 4399 of 16, has been published in the government gazette. It's a framework for the establishment of private investment aid for the regional economic development of the country. The development law offers subsidy of up to 55% free grant for investment projects in Greece, and is the ideal financial instrument to finance any type of investment. Emphasizes to strengthen the real economy of Greece, a tool to increase extroversion and innovativeness of business, an effectiveness way of financing investment projects. A tool to increase investments in Greece, a tool for providing major aid to any investment project. Who are the beneficiaries? All companies that are established or maintain a branch in Greece at the date that we apply for our approval to the investment law. And they can have all these corporate types. I think that all inclusive. About the sector of tourism. Establishment and expansion or modernization of complete hotel and camping units that are already or being upgraded to at least 3 or 2 stars in listing traditional or preservable buildings. Tourist accommodation complex development, at least 3 stars. Special tourism infrastructures, convention centers, golf courses, as we noticed before, tourist ports, marinas, and everything you can imagine, including the health tourism. And health tourism is something very special. I want to make you realize, I want to make you see a picture of what health tourism is. Imagine a fellow citizen who has problems, serial problems, serious issues with his kidneys. And he has to go to a special facility every 2 days just to connect with a machine to clean his blood. You know about this procedure? Imagine where this person can go for vacations. Nowhere. Now imagine a hotel that at the same time has the technological equipment of providing this service to this person with the doctors, the nurses, and everything. At the same time, it's a resort and it's a hospital. This is the future of health tourism. And this can be funding from the investment law. Agritourism or wine tourism facilities by cluster, establishment of youth hostels, tourist harbor services, marinas, because we had a lot of islands, waterway operation services. And for the industry, logistics, etc., if you want to develop a new plant, if you want to increase the capacity of an existing plant, diversification of plant productions, substantial modification of the entire production procedure of an existing plant, acquisition of all assets of a closed plant, transportation services with supply chain management only to 3PL, like 3PL logistic. I think that the most of all the investment projects are included here, and they can be funding from the investment law. There are a few exceptions I'd like to tell you. The steel sector, the synthetic fiber sector, the coal sector, the shipbuilding sector, the production, distribution and energy infrastructure sector, the transportation sector. All these sectors are not included to funding from the investment law. These are the exceptions. Those rules came from the European Union, are not from the Greek government. The type of aids. How can we take money from the investment law? First of all, it's tax exemption. If a company has to pay taxes, they will not pay taxes. She will not pay taxes. Second is subsidy. Subsidy, it's free provision from the state, from the European Union, to cover part of the expenses of the investment plan. Leasing subsidy, wage subsidy, if you want to create jobs, financing instruments, fixed corporate income tax rate. This is for the big investment, as we saw in a previous presentation about the investment more than 15 million euros, and fast licensing procedures, the fast track, as we said before. The aid intensities are from 10% to a very large company who apply to 55% of the whole budget of the investment to a small medium company. And there are top limits, as you can see, for each investment, the top is 5 million euros. For each company, because they can make two investments in two different sectors, 10 million, and for each company group, 20 million. These are the SIMS, machinery and equipment, general and preserved. These are, as can I say, the sectors of the investment law, and every investment project, according to from its, how can I say? Yes, it's, thank you very much. We can say that there are categories of investment, and any investment project goes under of exact categories according to their characteristics. And now I'm going to show you some project. This is the Pomegranate Hotel in Chalkidiki. It's about 20 million euros. This is the Electra Palace at the central place in Syntagma Square, Ermou Road, Ermou Street in Athens. This is Portobello Regal of Atlantica. Atlantica also runs an investment, if you have here, in Afandu Beach in Rhodes, in about 250 million euros. We are the consulting company for Atlantica. You can see Mykonian Collection, a great resort in Mykonos. Club Med in Evi Island. This is the President Hotel in Kifisias Avenue, in Athens. Tivani Collection, also in Athens. Sheraton, Elysium in Rhodes. This is Macedonia Palace, Macedonia Palace in Thessaloniki, Thessaloniki. This is the Thermes Hill Spa in Northern Evia, Edipsos, the city of Edipsos. This is the Atlantis Aquila from the Heraklio in Crete. Nana Beach Resort, one of the most famous resorts in Greece, most awarded, I think. Saint Nicholas Bay, La Marquise. And of course, the large investment in Astir Palace in Vouliagmeni. As we hear in a previous presentation, it will be approximately 800 million euros. It's the biggest investment nowadays in Greece, and more projects that were running from us in various places of Greece. I will be at your disposal for any questions after the lunch. Thank you very much for your attention.
Okay, ladies and gentlemen, thank you very much for being here. And now it's time to have a break, have some lunch, networking lunch. So please feel free to learn a bit more about the investment opportunities presented here today. As I said, you can contact me, my colleagues, or directly the companies from Greece that are here. And I hope we have a nice afternoon with some quality networking. Thank you very much again.
So my name is Richard Skoufias. Today I am advising investors, particularly on doing business in Greece. I'm the managing director of a London-based company. One of my connections into Greece is that for the last 7 years I used to actually manage one of the major investments in Greece in the energy sector.
Could you please tell me how did you find today's event? And because my question is not going to be heard in during the report. Please start like today's event, blah, blah, blah.
I think that today's event was actually very good. I think that bringing together prospective investors for Greece with people representing both the investment authorities in Greece, but also people who are already successfully doing business in Greece is critical. I think it highlights the fact that there are significant opportunities now coming up in Greece, in particularly which invites for first mover advantage as the country is clearly taking a turn and now going on a very good path.
There is a kind of a myth all around Europe and probably the rest of the world that it's very difficult to do business in Greece because of the bureaucracy or the business environment, generally speaking. What's your opinion?
I think that doing business anywhere in the world has its complexity. Greece is no exception to this. Of course, there are challenges to people who want to do business in Greece. I think that after a sustained period of very difficult economic times and certainly a certain amount of political volatility as well, Greece is offers its complexities, absolutely. But equally, and I think more importantly, I also think that the image which today exists about Greece and in particularly business opportunities in Greece is skewed. I think that there is often a prevailing negative sentiment which does not represent necessarily the reality. having managed a very big business endeavor in Greece for almost a decade, I've had excellent collaboration with the government as well as the previous government. I have found very, very enthused and capable organizations. So I think one of the key benefits of an event such as today is to strike that really good balance. It is not rose-tinted everything, but it is also certainly not the doom and gloom.
Στέφανος Θεοδωρίδης, είμαι διευθύνων σύμβουλος στην εταιρεία TMS. Η σημερινή εκδήλωση έχει πολύ μεγάλο ενδιαφέρον. Θεωρώ ότι ο ορισμός και βέβαια και οι ειδικές μορφές τουρισμού, όπως αυτό που συζητήσαμε σήμερα, που αφορά τουρισμό και υγεία, βρίσκονται σε σημαντική ανάπτυξη σε όλο τον κόσμο αλλά και στην Ελλάδα. Και πιστεύω γενικά ότι όλου αυτού του είδους οι δραστηριότητες και εκδηλώσεις βοηθάνε να να βελτιωθεί και η εικόνα και η επενδυσιμότητα της Ελλάδος. Άρα νομίζω ότι ήταν ένα καλό event με πολύ καλό ακροατήριο.
Στην ομιλία σας, κάνατε λόγο για τα μελλοντικά σχέδια της Κώστα Ναβαρίνο. Θα θέλατε να μας πείτε δύο λόγια για αυτά?
Ναι, μέχρι σήμερα, όπως έχουμε ξαναπεί, Κώστα Ναβαρίνο είναι ένας καινούριος προορισμός που αποτελείται από 4 μεγάλα επιμέρους integrated resorts. Σήμερα λειτουργούν το Ναβάρινο Dunes με τα δύο ξενοδοχεία πολυτελείας, γήπεδο golf και άλλες υποδομές. Το επόμενο στάδιο είναι στο να αναπτύξουμε δύο ακόμα ξενοδοχεία μας στο Ναβάρινο Bay, τα οποία συμπληρώνουν αυτή την περιοχή μαζί με το γήπεδο golf που λειτουργεί εκεί. Άρα τα επόμενα χρόνια είμαστε πολύ θετικοί για το περιβάλλον και τον τουρισμό στην Ελλάδα. Γι' αυτό έχουμε πάρει την απόφαση να επενδύσουμε περίπου άλλα 200-250 εκατομμύρια.
Αν θα μπορούσατε να μας πείτε με δύο λόγια τι θα μπορούσε να γίνει στον ελληνικό τουρισμό ώστε να αυξηθεί ακόμα περισσότερο η κίνηση ξένων προς την Ελλάδα για τουριστικούς λόγους?
Κοιτάξτε, υπάρχουν δύο-τρία πράγματα. Το ένα είναι βέβαια να συνεχίσουμε να επενδύουμε σε υποδομές, αεροδρόμια, λιμάνια, δρόμους. Υπάρχουν περιορισμοί, υπάρχουν προορισμοί αυτή τη στιγμή στην Ελλάδα οι οποίοι έχουν ήδη πλησιάσει τον πάνω του όριο. Άρα, όσο βελτιώνουμε τις υποδομές, τόσο μεγαλύτερη θα είναι η εμπειρία του πελάτη. Το δεύτερο αφορά όλους εμάς που είμαστε στον χώρο του τουρισμού. Τελικά, οι πελάτες όταν έρχονται σήμερα θέλουν πραγματική προστιθέμενη αξία, θέλουν πραγματικές εμπειρίες, θέλουν να όχι μόνο να περνάνε καλά, αλλά θέλουν να μαθαίνουν και να βιώνουν πράγματα και να έχουν συμπαθή με τις τοπικές εμπειρίες. Υπάρχει ένα θέμα βεβαίως που συζητάμε και ξαναλέμε με την φορολόγηση του τουριστικού προϊόντος και στο επίπεδο του F&B, ας πούμε, στο επίπεδο των εστιατορίων και των μπαρ. Θεωρούμε ότι είναι πολύ ψηλά εκεί που είναι σήμερα. Αλλά και στο θέμα του τουρισμού στο σύνολό του.
Είμαι ο Αντώνης Δαρμής και είμαι διευθυντής της εταιρείας Προτέας, η οποία έχει ένα πολύ ενδιαφέρον και μεγάλο ακίνητο στην περιοχή Σκορπονέρια του νομού Ευβίας. Είναι μια έκταση 270 περίπου στρέμματα, εντός σχεδίου πόλης, δίπλα από έναν οργανωμένο οικισμό των βουλευτών πολιτεία, όπου εκεί έχουμε πάρει εγκρίσεις για να δημιουργηθεί μια μαρίνα 100 σκαφών, να γίνουν χώροι αναψυχής και εμπορίου και να γίνουν και μια σειρά από κατοικίες. Μπορούμε συνολικά να χτίσουμε με τους βοητικούς χώρους περίπου 60.000 τετραγωνικά μέτρα. Η θέση του ακινήτου είναι πάρα πολύ καλή, αφενός μεν γιατί το περιβάλλον είναι πολύ όμορφο, είναι σε έναν κόλπο που προστατεύεται από τους ανέμους τους καλοκαιρινούς, η θάλασσα είναι πάντα ήρεμη, υπάρχουν ήπιες κλίσεις στο έδαφος και βρίσκεται μόλις μια ώρα σχεδόν από την Αθήνα. Δηλαδή είναι γύρω στα 100 χιλιόμετρα. Από το αεροδρόμιο θα κάνει κανείς μια ώρα και ένα τέταρτο. Είμαι εδώ λοιπόν για να δείξω αυτό το project, να παρουσιάσω τα σχέδιά μας. Έχουμε κάνει ένα πολύ ενδιαφέρον master plan. Θα θέλαμε όμως να το ολοκληρώσουμε με κάποιον επενδυτή που θα συνεργαστεί μαζί μας με κάποια μορφή. Θα θελήσει να μας δώσει και εκείνος την εμπειρία, ώστε μαζί με τη δική μας να φτιάξουμε ένα layout τέτοιο, το οποίο να έχει εμπορικό ενδιαφέρον και κυρίως να μπορούμε να απευθυνθούμε σε μια αγορά που ο επενδυτής θα μπορεί να φτάσει πιο εύκολα από εμάς. Αυτός είναι ο γενικός στόχος. Εμείς έχουμε προχωρήσει και έχουμε σχεδόν όλες τις άδειες. Είναι δηλαδή ένα project που μπορεί να υλοποιηθεί σχεδόν άμεσα. Κάτι που, όπως ξέρετε, δεν είναι εύκολο να το βρει κανείς στην Αθήνα. Δεν είναι εύκολο να έχει ξεμπλέξει με όλες τις υπηρεσίες, δασαρχία, πολεοδομίας, χρήσης γης κτλ. Είδατε στην παρουσίαση που έγινε εδώ προηγουμένως από τις εταιρείες Κωνσταντακάτου, Τεμές κτλ. Ότι χρειάστηκε οι άνθρωποι να κάνουν 20 χρόνια για να μπουν σε ποτά και να μπορούν να χτίζουν σήμερα. Εμείς λοιπόν όλα αυτά τα έχουμε ξεπεράσει. Είναι ένα όριμο έργο και φιλοδοξούμε και με τη δικιά σας βοήθεια να βρούμε ανθρώπους που θα θέλαν να συνεργαστούν μαζί μας και να προχωρήσουμε στην ανάπτυξη αυτού του έργου.
Κυρία, θέλετε να μας πείτε δύο λόγια για το πώς σας φάνηκε το σημερινό συνέδριο?
Αυτά τα συνέδρια είναι πάρα πολύ χρήσιμα. Κανείς ποτέ δεν μπορεί να προβλέψει τι θα γίνει, γιατί είναι και θέμα τύχης. Κάποιος μπορεί να ακούσει την πληροφορία και είτε άμεσα είτε έμεσα, δηλαδή δίδοντάς την σε κάποιον τρίτο, τελικά να αξιοποιηθεί στο μέλλον. Γι' αυτό ήρθαμε και εμείς εδώ. Δεν περιμέναμε τον επενδυτή να τον βρούμε σήμερα, αλλά νομίζω ότι πολλές τέτοιες προσπάθειες δημιουργούν προοπτικές για πολλά ίδια έργα σαν τα δικά μας, και υπάρχουν τέτοια project στην Ελλάδα, πολλά, που ιδιαίτερα αυτή την εποχή που ψάχνουμε όλοι εναγωνίως να βρούμε ξένους κυρίως επενδυτές λόγω των προβλημάτων που έχουν οι τράπεζες και κυρίως της ρευστότητας που είναι ανεπαρκής, θεωρώ λοιπόν ότι καλό θα είναι να συνεχιστούν τέτοιες ενέργειες και εμείς πιστεύω θα συμμετέχουμε και θα προωθήσουμε αυτές τις ιδέες.
Να σας ρωτήσω κάτι άλλο. Παρά το γεγονός ότι φαίνεται πως, εν πάση περιπτώσει, με τον έναν ή τον άλλο τρόπο βγαίνουμε σιγά σιγά από αυτό το κυκαιώνα των μνημονίων και των περιοριστικών μέτρων, υπάρχει ακόμα ένας ενδιασμός από τους ξένους για την Ελλάδα? Είναι κάτι που εσείς το έχετε νιώσει, το έχετε δει? Παρά το γεγονός ότι, όπως λέτε, στη δική σας περίπτωση έχουν ξεπεραστεί πολλά προβλήματα.
Κοιτάξτε, δυστυχώς στο παρελθόν έχουμε δείξει άσχημα δείγματα γραφής. Έχουν τρομάξει πολλοί επενδυτές. Ξέρετε πολύ καλά και ακούτε και εσείς στην αγορά είσαστε τα προβλήματα που βγήκανε με το ελληνικό, τα προβλήματα που βγήκανε με τις επενδύσεις του Κουβέιτ, στη Ζάκυνθο κτλ. Αυτά σίγουρα δεν είναι θετικά. Θεωρώ όμως ότι θα ακολουθήσουμε μια ανωδική πορεία στο μέλλον. Δηλαδή φτάσαμε στον πάτο που λένε όλοι οι επιχειρηματίες πια στην Ελλάδα και βλέπω ότι είμαστε όριμοι για να αρχίσουμε μια αναπτυξιακή πορεία. Ευελπιστώ ότι όλα θα πάνε καλύτερα στο μέλλον.
Ευχαριστώ πολύ.
Ευχαριστώ και εγώ. Γεια σας.
Εγώ είμαι Σωτήρης Γιαμάκος, αρχιτέκτον.
Και την εταιρεία Mentor.
Είμαι συνεργάτης με την εταιρεία Mentor σε θέματα αρχιτεκτονικής, σχεδιασμού κτλ.
Εγώ είμαι ο Σταύρος Ανδρινός, είμαι αρχιτέκτονας, είμαι αναπληρωτής καθηγητής στο Δημοκρίτιο Πανεπιστήμιο της Θράκης και είμαι επίσης συνεργάτης και εκπροσωπώ την εταιρεία Mentor σήμερα εδώ.
Λοιπόν, το πρώτο ερώτημα είναι λοιπόν ποιος είναι ο λόγος της παρουσίας σας εδώ και ποιο είναι ακριβώς το τουριστικό project το οποίο αυτή τη στιγμή προωθείτε?
Ωραία, το πολυθεματικό πάρκο στους Δελφούς είναι ένα ιδιαίτερο project, ξεχωριστό από ό,τι συνηθίζεται όταν μιλάμε για τουριστική ανάπτυξη. Είναι ένα θεματικό πάρκο εστιασμένο στον πολιτισμό, στο περιβάλλον, στην οικολογία. Προσφέρει διαφορετικά πλεονεκτήματα στην ανάπτυξη του τουρισμού που έχουν να κάνουν με την προσοχή στην υγεία των ανθρώπων, για παράδειγμα, προσοχή στους ηλικιωμένους. Και βέβαια προτείνει ένα περιβάλλον αναβαθμισμένο, που δεν τεχνητό περιβάλλον αναβαθμισμένο. Θα δείτε ότι και στο βίντεο που παρουσιάζουμε υπάρχει μια μεγάλη τεχνητή λίμνη. Δίνει τη δυνατότητα μικρές τουριστικές μονάδες να μπαίνουν μέσα στο νερό, να αξιοποιείται ο πλούτος που υπάρχει στην περιοχή δίνοντας προσοχή στην ανάδειξή του και γενικά να προβάλλουμε ένα διαφορετικό προϊόν στο διεθνή χώρο, διαφοροποιημένο από το συνήθι μαζικό τουρισμό που έχουμε στα μεγάλα ξενοδοχεία κτλ. Με κύρια αιχμή τον πολιτισμό και τη φύση της Ελλάδος.
Το γεγονός λοιπόν ότι αναζητάτε διεθνή χρηματοδότηση, ενδεχομένως διεθνή συμβολή στο να ολοκληρωθεί, να λειτουργήσει και να προοδεύσει αυτό το project. καθορίζεται από τι? Είναι ούτως ή άλλως κάτι εξωστρεφές ή σχετίζεται και με το πώς είναι αυτή τη στιγμή το επενδυτικό περιβάλλον στη χώρα και οι πηγές χρηματοδότησης ενδεχομένως?
Δεν υπάρχουν στην Ελλάδα, το ξέρετε πολύ καλά τα πράγματα πώς είναι. Δεν είναι πολύ δύσκολο project αυτού του μεγέθους τουλάχιστον να υποστηριχθούν. Χρειάζονται συνέργειες και χρειάζονται και οπωσδήποτε δυνάμεις από το διεθνή χώρο. Φαντάζομαι θα υπάρχουν συνεργασίες και με τοπικές, τίποτα δεν πρόκειται να έρθει από μακριά και μόνο του. Χρειάζεται πολλή προσπάθεια. Εσείς κάνετε πολύ μεγάλη προσπάθεια. Αυτό που γίνεται εδώ γίνεται και σε άλλες χώρες, βλέπουμε. Και ελπίζουμε ότι σιγά σιγά δεν είναι τόσο εύκολο. Σιγά σιγά θα περάσουν τα μηνύματα και ίσως δουν αυτό που κάνουμε. Εμείς πιστεύουμε ότι θα υπάρξει αποτέλεσμα. Χρειάζεται λίγο υπομονή, αλλά θα υπάρξει.
Θα ρωτήσω, αν θέλετε να προσθέσετε πάνω στο ίδιο.
Πιστεύω ότι είναι ένα πολύ φιλόδοξο και καινοτόμο project, το οποίο προσπαθεί να συνδυάσει διάφορα πράγματα που είναι πολύ καινούργια και ίσως ήδη τα θεματικά πάρκα, παρότι πολλά χρόνια τα λέμε, δεν υπάρχει κάτι αντίστοιχο αυτή τη στιγμή στην Ελλάδα. Και προσπαθεί να συνδυάσει ουσιαστικά τον πολιτισμό, προσπαθεί να συνδυάσει την κουλτούρα και προσπαθεί να συνδυάσει επίσης και την παράδοση. Μαζί με τουριστικές υπηρεσίες υψηλού επίπεδου που αφορούν και τον τουρισμό σε σχέση με την υγεία ή τον τουρισμό σε σχέση με τον αθλητισμό ή σε σχέση με την κουλτούρα. Κάτι που μπορεί να αλλάξει το τοπίο του τι θεωρούμε τουριστικό κατάλημα στην Ελλάδα και το περιεχόμενό του με έναν τρόπο.
Επειδή αναφέρατε ότι χρειάζεται και προσπάθεια, πώς είναι η αλήθεια η προοπτική, πώς τη βλέπετε? Είστε άνθρωποι του τουρισμού, προσπαθείτε να κάνετε πράγματα. Πιστεύετε ότι η όποια κατάσταση υπάρχει αυτή τη στιγμή έχει προοπτική βελτίωσης, βλέποντας ενδεχομένως και το ότι η χώρα σιγά σιγά ας πούμε ανακάμπτει?
Αυτό που εμείς συναντάμε παντού στο εξωτερικό όταν βγαίνουμε για αυτό το project είναι ένα ζήτημα που θέτουν όλοι για ένα σταθερό πλαίσιο φορολογικό στην Ελλάδα, για ένα σταθερό πολιτικό σκηνικό, δηλαδή μας ρωτάνε πότε θα έχετε εκλογές και πρέπει να ξέρουμε την ημερομηνία. Όλα αυτά φαίνονται αστεία σε εμάς, αλλά είναι πολύ σοβαρά και πίσω από κάθε τέτοια ερώτηση παίρνονται αποφάσεις. Και οι αποφάσεις αυτές έχουν να κάνουν αν θα έρθουν σε εμάς ή αν θα πάνε στην Ιταλία, αν θα πάνε στην Τουρκία. Είναι πολύ σημαντικές αποφάσεις. Λοιπόν, σιγά σιγά αρχίζουμε και καταλαβαίνουμε τι γίνεται σε αυτό το χώρο. Αλλά νομίζω ότι τα πράγματα είναι θετικά. Δεν απογοητευόμαστε. Μπορούν αυτά να ελεγχθούν και θα έχουμε θετικές εξελίξεις. Θέλει προσπάθεια όμως και στην Ελλάδα. Πολύ προσπάθεια.
Υπάρχει κάτι που θα μπορούσε να γίνει γρήγορα στο να βελτιωθούν, στην Ελλάδα εννοώ, και από την Ελλάδα για να βελτιωθούν οι δικές σας πιθανότητες να προσελκύσετε κόσμο από το εξωτερικό?
Νομίζω τα είπαμε πριν. Πρέπει να αυτό το θέμα, το φορολογικό πλαίσιο να οριστικοποιηθεί. Καλό κακό πρέπει να γίνει σαφές και σταθερό. Και θα πρέπει και όταν λέμε κάτι να το εννοούμε. Δηλαδή η αξιοπιστία πρέπει να την αποδεικνύεις ότι την έχεις. Όταν λέμε κάτι πρέπει να το κάνουμε. Όχι να λέμε α και να κάνουμε β. Αυτό τώρα δεν θα το εξειδικεύσω, αλλά ξέρετε πολύ καλά τι γίνεται.
Θα ήθελα να μας πείτε και δύο κουβέντες για τη σημερινή εκδήλωση. Πώς σας φάνηκε, τι πιστεύετε?
Ναι, νομίζω ότι υπήρχαν πολύ θετικά δείγματα σήμερα από αυτή την εκδήλωση. Δηλαδή άκουσα και ότι το κλίμα έχει αναστραφεί, ότι υπάρχει πια ένα καλύτερο κλίμα για τις επενδύσεις στην Ελλάδα. Υπάρχει μια μεγαλύτερη εμπιστοσύνη πιθανόν. Και νομίζω ότι αυτό είναι πάρα πολύ θετικό ως προς αυτήν την κατεύθυνση.
Ευχαριστώ πολύ. Μίλτος Καμπουρίδης, founder Dolphin Capital Partners.
Λοιπόν, κύριε Καμπουρίδη, πείτε μας λίγο για την παρουσία σας σήμερα στην ημερίδα εδώ. Τι ακριβώς είναι αυτό που παρουσιάζει η Dolphin Capital Partners και ποιος ήταν ο στόχος της συμμετοχής?
Καταρχήν, σαν Dolphin Capital στηρίζουμε πάντα τέτοιες πρωτοβουλίες που προωθούν την Ελλάδα και τις επενδυτικές ευκαιρίες στη χώρα μας. Εμείς εδώ αντιπροσωπεύουμε τον τομέα αυτό που ασχολείται με τις επενδύσεις σε υψηλού επίπεδου resorts. Με αυτά που έχουμε ήδη δημιουργήσει και αυτά που προγραμματίζουμε να δημιουργήσουμε, θέλουμε να εξηγήσουμε στον κόσμο γιατί η Ελλάδα έχει τα πλεονεκτήματα για τη δημιουργία τέτοιων resorts.
Θεωρείτε ότι είναι αυτή τη στιγμή εύκολο ή δύσκολο να πιστούν, να προσελκυστούν, εν πάση περιπτώσει, επενδυτές από το εξωτερικό για κάποια project στην Ελλάδα?
Είναι δύσκολο, αλλά γίνεται ευκολότερο. Με την έννοια ότι πλέον το country risk μειώνεται. Πλέον το θέμα του Brexit έχει βγει από την ατζέντα. Το γεγονός ότι η παγκόσμια οικονομία πάει καλά, το γεγονός ότι η πολιτική κατάσταση δεν είναι τόσο ασταθής όσο μπορεί να ήταν πριν λίγα χρόνια, αυτό δημιουργεί ένα καλύτερο περιβάλλον. Φυσικά υπάρχει δρόμος ακόμα για να βελτιωθούν τα πράγματα, αλλά νομίζω πάμε προς το καλύτερο.
Εσείς που τα ζείτε άμεσα, ναι. Υπάρχουν κάποιες κινήσεις που θα μπορούσαν να γίνουν σχετικά γρήγορα από την ελληνική πλευρά και θα ωφελούσαν την κατάσταση ως προς την προσέλκυση επενδύσεων?
Επειδή ο κόσμος κοιτάει τα παραδείγματα που γίνονται στην Ελλάδα, αν ξεμπλοκαριστούν οι μεγάλες επενδύσεις, θα είναι ένα πολύ μεγάλο βήμα προς αυτή την κατεύθυνση. Συγκεκριμένα το ελληνικό, για παράδειγμα, εάν ξεκινήσει, θα είναι κάτι πολύ καλό. Αλλά γενικά, όσο περισσότερες επιτυχημένες επενδύσεις υπάρχουν στην Ελλάδα, τόσο περισσότερο αυτά αποτελούν παραδείγματα προς μίμηση για άλλους. Επομένως, πρέπει να υπάρχει μια συνεργασία όλων των παραγόντων και του ιδιωτικού και του δημόσιου τομέα, ώστε οποιαδήποτε προβλήματα υπάρχουν να λύνονται και να γίνονται πράγματα.
Και σε ό,τι αφορά πάλι την Dolphin Capital, ποια ακριβώς θα μπορείτε να αναφερθείτε σε κάποια projects που τρέχουν ή που θα τρέξουν?
Αυτό που έχουμε ανακοινώσει πρόσφατα είναι η έναρξη της δημιουργίας του One and Only στο νησί της Σκαίας. Αυτό πιστεύω θα είναι ακόμα ένα κόσμημα για την Ελλάδα, όπως είναι το Amanzoi, και μαζί θα αποτελούν από τα κορυφαία resorts της Μεσογείου. Και ετοιμάζουμε και κάποια άλλα. Αλλά προς το παρόν, όλη η προσοχή εστιάζεται στο One and Only στη Τζιά.
Ευχαριστούμε πολύ.